A breakdown to that 66.65 is nothing. Nothing bad at all. That is a setup. That is what we call a setup. Wow, guys, as you can see from that clip from yesterday's video, less than 24 hours ago, we already broke this smaller triangle. This smaller triangle has been absolutely shattered like my hopes and dreams at only 16 years old. Guys, this is exciting. I know a lot of you guys might be nervous, but that's why I came on to do this emergency update and talk about our targets, the next areas for Bitcoin. Is Bitcoin doom and gloom? Is it the end of? Or is the treasure just around the corner? Find out in this emergency update. Wow. Thank you guys so much for joining me here on this Monday, December 16th, 2019. Just one day, mind you, after what we talked about was gonna be a big move. I said it was gonna be December 15th. It did end up breaking down, guys. Wow. And look all across the board. You can see the entire crypto market, as always, dumping, guys. Very interesting stuff. We have so much to cover. We have to talk about our next patterns, what's going on with the market, how far can this thing fall? Because we're going to be taking a look at a few different scenarios here, and you guys are not going to want to miss out. Get out your notes, get out your pen, and start taking some notes, because class is in session, boys. So guys, so much to talk about today. There is so much going on in terms of this price action that we really need to just spend the whole episode delving into that. Maybe some uncertainty in some of your guys' minds, but that's what I'm here for. Tyler, technicalities without the technical analysis, that's what we do here. So guys, before we get into it, we have a little less than 2 weeks until we do this brand new treasure giveaway. All you do is leave a comment below. But as well, if you're new to the channel, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. Make sure to ding that bell. I'm so excited to get into this stuff with you guys. I live for technical analysis. It has been my passion since I was only 8 years old. When all the other kids were watching Disney Channel, my mother had my feet bound and my head in a textbook. So guys, believe that we're here and we're gonna just jump into this technical analysis. So as you remember from the clip earlier, we talked about this very, very tight position here that we were in. I got some comments on my video yesterday being like, oh, you have so many lines. Well, guys, we do a lot of lines on this channel. And if you wanna really just be prepared for anything, you gotta make sure you have the lines. Guys, check this out. I want to show you something, okay? Tell me what you think. You know, if I had this many lines on the screen, what does that look like? It looks like I'm a guy. What am I, some guy on the street that's never even done a technical analysis before? No, absolutely not, you guys. Let's get the lines, because the lines hold the secrets, and only these lines will show you all the secrets, but there's some other lines that'll show you the secrets, not just these lines. So the first thing I want to jump into, so we talked about this triangle here, this very small triangle, so that it did break out of that, guys. And so far, I want to actually zoom in, because this drop was actually pretty vertical. As with all drops in cryptocurrency, guys, it happens very, very, very fast. And that is why we stress so much about being prepared, because look at this. This is the 1 minute chart, guys. From, 1526 to 1826, actually exactly 3 hours. That's interesting. I didn't actually notice that until right now. It traded right on this very, very strict area right before breaking out. So 3 entire hours. And then within, what is this, about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe like less than 10 minutes, we went from 7,085 down to 6,823. Okay, now that's not huge, but the market has been pretty calm lately in terms of volatility. The market has been relatively calm in terms of volatility, so a $200 move on these charts actually looks pretty big. Again, at where we're at right now, we're seeing a very similar situation in terms of a very, very horizontal move. But guys, in my opinion, in the short term, I think we can expect more downside, and I have some reasons and things I want to say about that. But guys, keep in mind, I'm talking on short time frames, okay? We're talking weekly, we're talking even the end of this year, and maybe a month or two from now. I am expecting still such a massive move. I think it could come at any time. I really think we need actually a little more downside, like we talked about in yesterday's video, before we get that massive candle. Bitcoin absolutely thrives on volatility. Let me tell you that, guys. And what I mean by that is these moves like this are exactly what you should be excited about. Some people get upset because they're red instead of green. People love the red, people love the green, and they hate the red. But you need both. If you want your dreams to come true, you're gonna have to battle your demons sometimes. If we take a look on this chart here, actually. This descending wedge, so optimally, I wanna talk to you about scenario one, which I think is the best case scenario. Some of you guys might not like this scenario because you don't think it's realistic. And again, there's some probabilities we need to get into with some of these other patterns, but the best case scenario, I think, for the mid to short term, this, and we're not talking about long term, we're talking about a week or two. The best case scenario, or even less, so within 2 weeks probably, best case scenario is we continue to pull back, touch on this bottom of this descending, this falling wedge. And guys, like I said in the clip at the beginning, and like from yesterday, it's okay if we actually go a little below that. as long as we maintain and have a quick reversal at some point. Okay guys, so recognize that. So that gives us about another candle, essentially the exact same size as the one we have so far today. Another drop about a few $100s. We could go about $300, even $400, and it would still be fine, guys. Now, you might be thinking, okay, so we get a pullback to here, and then what, are we just gonna bounce up? That is one possibility, but we have to take a look at more possibilities because there are more possibilities. And both of them could lead, in fact, to a huge green bounce. Great candle. This next possibility would take a little bit longer, most likely, unless we saw a massive move like this. Okay, these are a little rare. You know, we don't get these all the time, but at the end of these moves, they are very likely, more likely. Another thing we could see is, and this is kind of like, this is option two, it's possible, but if we break out of that, we could see ourselves going to the bottom of this channel yet again, guys. And the reason I say that is because we have touched on the bottom of this channel, or we have actually fluctuated in between this channel literally dozens of times at this point. You know, you get like three here, three here, three here, you get like six here, okay? You got like four or five right here. You got two right here, okay guys? You got like three right here. You have like 15 right here, all touching the edges there. We had two just a few weeks ago here. And now, again, it's possible to come back and visit the bottom of this channel again, guys. It has happened so many times. Okay, so that's the second scenario. Both of these are actually bullish, and we're gonna talk about more scenarios as well, but these are my top two favorite scenarios right now. So number one was falling out of that falling wedge and then having a break up. And the second one we have here is actually falling to the bottom of this gigantic 7-month descending channel here. And guys, that would bring us down to about here. Now, why is that so critical? That is critical now. For the first time throughout this entire descending channel, we are below this market structure, this purple line. So we need a strong bounce there. We need a strong bounce either here or here. If we go below 6,000, guys, it is a whole new ball game. And I might be having to accept my friend's offer. And boy, I don't think it's worth the money. I do not want to do that, if you know what I mean. So another interesting thing, we actually use Bitstamp, but I want to use Coinbase here, actually. Because with the fluctuations in this chart, this is a much more simplified chart. Basically using a lot of the data, but then taking it and then just swapping it over to the Coinbase chart here, which is slightly different data, pretty much the same. But then also we just have different indicators, just less. We clean it up a little bit. So for all you guys that don't like seeing all those lines, here are some less lines for you. You can't handle all the lines, then maybe you shouldn't take all the lines, guys. So here, actually, what's interesting now is that this actual move is at the very bottom of this market structural line for this one. And so is this move here. And again, you see the descending, the descending wedge right here, the falling wedge. But now what's interesting too, guys, this is a straight line, right? This is a straight line. Look at this. Goes back to here and look where it catches up. Goes back and actually keeps going back. You can see that actually becomes the top and so forth. It kind of fluctuates. I could draw that line further back. But this chart only does go back to like 2015, so I didn't bother finishing off there. It's not as quite as long of a chart as we like to use, but you can see here, this structural line, look at this. Even just this line here goes about back about 5 or 6 years, okay? So this is about four to six years of a structural line here. And again, right now, last time we touched that, okay, was the bottom of the market. Or so we think so far, the end of 2018, beginning of 2019. And now for the first time, we are testing it again. Now keep in mind, just because we might fall through it does not invalidate this, but it would invalidate it if we did not have a quick bounce. And guys, that is why we are expecting a quick bounce. We nailed the move because we knew that all of this condensing and consolidating would have to end in a move. And now the same thing is true for this. We need to see a bounce at some time soon, or boy, we are in for it. Now, I do wanna address some things. A lot of the girls and guys' comments below are pretty reasonable. We see some 5,000, 6,000 as like load targets, 4,000 even. But then we get people who are commenting like 1,800, guys. And all I wanna say to that is maybe you should lay off the Flintstones gummies, start eating some apples and bananas because your brain is a little wacky. Wow, Tone Bays, guys, if you're actually right about the 1,800, if you guys are actually right about that, come back to this video, comment below. I will send you an apology card in the mail, and I'll put something that you request inside of it. Wow, thank you guys so much for watching. This is a really exciting time. The prices are absolutely crazy. Buckle in, guys, because this is all part of the plan. This is all part of the setup. And as well, guys, just make sure to check out the links in the bio. I will see you in the next video. Love you. God bless. And we're cowboys, and we love to, we are the cowboys of the Wild Wild West, and we're just doing what we think is right.